Hi everybody, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today, I will try to explain to you something about our lesson, lesson 1A and lesson 1B. So now I will open the lesson. Yeah, I will start with lesson 1A. In the lesson 1A, I will explain to you. Yeah. So you can see this is the sand layer, and this is the grammar of the sand layer. This is the grammar unsaturated, and this is the grammar of the saturated. And what does it mean? It means, I will come back here to explain. This means that when we put the groundwater level here, for example, and to calculate the soil stress in this zone above the groundwater level, above the water, the Plaxis software will use this number and to calculate the soil stress under the groundwater level. This means that the soil is in the water. They will use this number to calculate the soil stress and everything else. So it is the meaning of this number. And the next, the K zero is 0.5 in the X direction and in the Z direction. So as all of you may know that for example we have the soil particle here, right? And this is the sigma 1, this is a sigma 2, and this is a sigma 3. Sigma 1, sigma 2, and sigma 3. And sigma 2 equal to sigma 3, and sigma 1. In this case, equal to plus K0. So how to calculate the K0? How to calculate the K0? And here we have the formula to calculate the K0. Minus sin phi, and phi is the friction angle. In this case, we will have sin 30 degrees equal to 0.5. Okay, you can see that's the meaning of the phi, the friction angle here to calculate the K0 here. So that's some of the basic information you need to understand in the soil property. Okay, and now I will explain to you a little bit about foundation, about footing. Here, our model is to model the this sea. You know, this is the soil. This is the soil, and this zone is the. It's only the. We have footing here, footing here. Okay. And this is the. This is the circular footing, with the diameter. You see here, 1 meter is the radius. This is the radius. See the we have actually we have the circular footing, something like this. Yes. And the radius. The radius is 1 meter. Okay. So in the Plaxis program. They will cut a part of the footing with the angle here is 1. Radian. Right, 1 radian. The angle in the passage is 1 radian. Can see here. Okay, understand? You mean that's our model here. We have the footing here with the width with the width and the width of the model is you can imagine like that. One right here. See our model in the 3D view. So I will show you the rich value here. After the program analysis, we have the force. The force caused by the displacement is 93.56. I will make the calculation here for you to see 93.56 plus 2 plus pi. It's about 590 kilonewton of the force. So what does it mean? It means that we have here our circular footing and the total force. We have just calculated is 190 kilonewton. Here, this is the total force. From this total force, we can calculate the uniform load on our footing by dividing it by the area of the footing. This is the uniform load. So the area is easy, right? Area is easy to calculate the area. I will calculate the area. Pi plus d squared divided by 4, and you see 3.14. Square meter because the diameter of the footing is 2 and we have the area is 3.14 square meter. So we calculate this. and we will have Israel. Israel 188 kilonewton per square meter. Do you see this number is similar, familiar? You see, saw it somewhere, right? Okay, I will show you. Where did you see it? It is from lesson 3. Lesson 1B. We will come to the lesson 1B. You can see here in the structure. This is minus 188. This is the force, the uniform load, as we calculate from previous lesson. So now we'll come back to show you. In this lesson, we apply the displacement by 50 mm, and we have the soil, we have the force here, the total force. Total force of the footing. Total force is 560 kilonewton, and then we calculate the uniform force with uniform load E 188 kilonewton per square meter. Yes, in this lesson we know that. And in the lesson B, we applied the force like this. And you view the calculation result. You see the displacement is 50 mm. Remember, this is 50 mm. So, it is what I want to explain to you today, and I hope that you can learn something from this lesson to understand the basic of the program. It's very important. It's easy, it's basic, but it's very important to know before you can use the program professional. So thanks for watching, and if you have any question, please comment below this video. We will try to explain to you. See you. Bye bye for now.